It was a mostly cloudy day with afternoon showers, but if you're up early enough, you would have been treated to a beautiful sunrise. The sky tinted with orange and pinks as commuters made their way into the city this morning. Now, temperatures a little cooler than average across our western suburbs today, only reaching 23 in Richmond and Penrith, 25 in Parramatta, Liverpool and Campbelltown, 25 in the city and 27 in Cronulla. The heaviest rain fell in Penrith, picking up 7 millimetres, 6 millimetres falling in Seven Hills, Toongabby, and in Mona Vale. Across New South Wales right now, there is a storm warning for large hail and damaging winds around the northern tablelands. The heaviest rain so far has fallen in the central tablelands, 18 millimetres in Orange and 17 millimetres falling in Bathurst. It has been fairly warm everywhere with tops in the mid to late 20s with the exception of Bathurst, only reaching a chilly 18 degrees. Tomorrow, troughs in the east will trigger rain and storms in Tasmania, Victoria, New South Wales and into southern Queensland. Brisbane is expecting a shower or two tomorrow, heading for a top of 31 degrees, showers and a possible storm in Canberra, 22. Showers clearing in Melbourne, 18 degrees. Just a few showers in Adelaide, 21. And a lovely day on the way for Perth, 27 degrees. Most of New South Wales will see some rain tomorrow with heavy falls in the northwest around Inverell and Tamworth and southwest around Goulburn and Canberra. It will be windy along the coast with a strong wind warning from the Macquarie coast all the way down to Eden. After early fog in the west, Sydney will be partly cloudy tomorrow with showers throughout the day, most likely easing in the late afternoon. We could also see a storm possibly severe. There is an 80% chance we'll see some rain with up to 4 millimetres forecast right across the basin. Heading for a top of 28 degrees in Richmond, Kellyville and Blacktown, 27 on the way for Liverpool and Campbelltown, 26 in Terry Hills and 28 in Gosford and in the city. Let's take a look ahead and a shower or two on Thursday, heading for a top of 24 degrees. Sunny on a Friday with a top of 24. Possible showers across the weekend, heading for tops of just 22, so really cooling down. And those nights also getting cooler from a low of 20 tonight down to a chilly 14 degrees by Friday morning. In our west, partly cloudy on Thursday, 26 degrees, blue skies and sunshine on Friday. Then just a possible shower or two across the weekend, only heading for a top of 22 degrees on Sunday. Pete?
Hello again. Autumn sunshine made a welcome return today and that made it a little warmer around Melbourne. The city peaked at 21 degrees. Northern suburbs did even better with maximums of 25 at Epping and Yarra Glen, 24 at Scoresby and light winds added to the pleasant Tuesday conditions. Western parts of the state had a cooler day though. Horsham only made it to 20 degrees, Hamilton and Warrnambool 19, but it was mild through Gippsland with maximums in the mid-20s. Northern districts were a mixed bag, 25 at Swan Hill and Charlton, but 28 at the beautiful Rutherglen and also Wodonga. There's been a few light showers in coastal and eastern parts throughout the day, and storms picked up this afternoon, and they're likely to continue overnight through the east, potentially severe. A severe thunderstorm warning is currently in place through far eastern parts of the state with the risk of heavy rain and large hail. And in the west, storms in South Australia could move over the border into the Mallee tonight. There's been extensive storm activity along the east coast today. They're being fed by this northwest cloud band, and tomorrow heavier falls are expected along the eastern seaboard, and this trough through the north will drag very humid air across parts of Queensland. Tomorrow, Brisbane is expected to reach 29 with showers from the late morning and a possible storm. Early showers for Sydney heading for 28 degrees. Hobart 22 degrees with an early shower. A cool day for Adelaide 21 with a chance of a shower, but Perth can expect dry and sunny skies on its way to a top of 27. Back home, eastern parts of the state, well, they'll be a lot wetter than the west with falls of 15 to 20 millimetres. And for much of the state, maximums will be quite a bit lower than today, especially through the north, just the low 20s, the high teens through the south. Showers are likely to pick up across Melbourne before dawn, so you will need an umbrella for the commute. They'll continue during the morning, clearing out through eastern suburbs in the afternoon, and they should leave behind totals of up to 10 to 15 millimetres in northern and outer eastern suburbs, a little less elsewhere. And after overnight minimums, mostly in the low teens, it should reach 18 or 19 degrees. Geelong is only expected to get a millimetre or two, and after dipping to 14, it's forecast to reach 20 degrees. It'll be cooler in the city with up to 8 millimetres and a top of just 18. Only a light sprinkle on Thursday and Friday, 19 degrees both days. Saturday is forecast to be the coldest day of the week, just 17. Grab that sunshine on Sunday, along with a top of 20. Then we could get more showers early next week, 23 on Monday, 24 on Tuesday. And showers are expected from around dawn tomorrow, clearing out through eastern suburbs in the afternoon. And after a low of 15, the city's heading for 18. I'm going to put my boys in raincoats for the school drop-off, Pete.
Andrew, I'm afraid we've got another 3 days of these above average temperatures and very high humidity. A couple of showers and storms thrown in there to make things even more uncomfortable. It should start to cool down slowly over the weekend, more so for Sunday and even cooler again into Monday. So next week, not too bad, but there's a bit of rain in the extended forecast as we edge a little closer towards our Easter break as well. But let's just get through the next few days. A nice evening here at South Bank if you want to cool off. Let's check temperatures across southeast Queensland. It was all about the highs today, and it was in the 30s right across the suburbs. 31 degrees here in the city, the Gold Coast, Archerfield, Logan, Ipswich, Caboolture and Gatton. The high 33 in Bow Desert, 30 for Redcliffe on the Sunshine Coast, 28 for Toowoomba. With the weather map, rain and storms for New South Wales and into southern Queensland late in the day. Cooler southwest winds and showers across Tassie, Victoria and South Australia. Interstate, we're looking at a cooler day, Adelaide, Melbourne and Hobart with a shower or two. Showers in Sydney and Canberra tomorrow with possible thunderstorms. Darwin looking at a mostly sunny day and 34 degrees. Queensland fine and low 30s. Cairns, Townsville and Mackay. Gladstone 31 as well. Rocky 34. Fine in Bundaberg and 31. Maryborough 32. Hot inland. We're looking at 36 for Mount Isa and Longreach. Afternoon showers and thunderstorms firing up in Roma. Here in the southeast, a partly clouded day with some scattered showers developing. The chance of a thunderstorm later. Light winds, daytime temperatures around 30 across all the suburbs. It will feel a couple of degrees warmer. Moreton Bay, northerlies 10 to 15 knots, turning northwest later, the seas below a metre. Brizzy, a little cloud, possible morning showers, but a higher chance in the afternoon of showers and storms and a top of 29 degrees. 7 day outlook, showers and storms Thursday, anytime from the morning. Mostly sunny Friday and 30, cooling down over the weekend with a shower or two. Temperatures back into the mid 20s from Sunday. Ipswich, showers and storms Thursday morning, mostly sunny 31 Friday, partly cloudy Saturday. A shower or two Sunday and Monday with some cooler days. The Gold Coast, scattered showers Thursday with a possible storm, possible shower Friday. A couple of showers over the weekend, temperatures cooling down, especially next week. Sunshine Coast, showers and storms for Thursday. Possible shower Friday, a shower or two over the weekend, increasing on Monday as temperatures drop back down into the mid-20s. So a couple more uncomfortable days, all due to the humidity, but it will finally cool down as we get towards the weekend, guys.
Thanks, Kate. Well, yeah, it's a little over a week until Easter, but it's actually right now that's the busiest time at our local chocolate factory because they've got so much work to do here at Hakes to get all of that chocolate ready. Temperature-wise today, 23.5 degrees. Right now, it's around 20 degrees in the city. Across the suburbs, a few showers around this afternoon, but we actually got away with a mostly dry start to the day. Still pretty warm at Mawson Lakes with 26 degrees there. On the charts, the low and the trough that delivered our showers are pushing off east, leaving us with a more of a stock standard southwesterly tomorrow. If you're travelling interstate tomorrow, there's plenty of weather still hanging around the eastern states. Melbourne looking wet with 18, and Sydney, the chance of showers and storms with 28. Across SA, it's a little bit hit and miss with the showers. Half a chance for Whyalla and Port Pirie, but I wouldn't bet on it. Temperatures in the low 20s around there. Port Lincoln going for 21 with a possible splash in the southeast. Narracourt is set for 21 as well. And Mount Gambier, a shower or two and 18 degrees. Adelaide suburbs are half a chance of light showers tomorrow, and anything we do see should clear up during the afternoon. 21 degrees for Elizabeth, 19 the top at Mount Barker. In the city, we're expecting that top of 21 degrees. Keep the brolly handy, you never know, an overnight low of around 15 degrees. And after that, well, showers are lingering for the rest of the week. Nothing guaranteed, but on and off. Don't be surprised if you see the odd light sprinkle with 21 degrees for Thursday and Friday. But it is clearing up for the weekend with 20 degrees on Saturday and up to a sunny 23 degrees on Sunday. Now, I know I mentioned the 30th anniversary of the Easter Bilby earlier, and you wouldn't believe it, Kate and Brenton, a very busy time for the Easter Bilby, but we have just bumped into him here at Hakes. He just wanted to very quickly pop out and wish everyone a happy Easter.